All right, our next contestant, give a big round of applause, keep it going for Mr. Adam Newman. Let him know.
Thank you. I was on a website where you upload your picture to the website and it uses face matching technology to find your closest celebrity match. My friend, who's a guy, got Angelina Jolie. It's like, oh, he's a guy, I got a girl, I'm gonna get a funny celebrity too. My celebrity lookalike was Anne Frank. And it was way closer than his. And my mom said, at least you got somebody Jewish. But here's my thing, anybody else think Anne Frank maybe shouldn't be on the list of celebs you can get on the site? Like, it should be a light, fun game that you play while you're screwing around in your free time at work, not something that immediately references the Holocaust. That's what I think. Those people using the site are just like 14-year-old girls comparing their celebrity lookalikes to each other, and they're like, I got Justin Timberlake. Who did you get? Adolf Eichmann, and they don't know who that is. Not yet. Like every other young, unathletic, white, flaily Jewish boy I grew up with, I thought I was going to be in the NBA until I was like 16. My favorite basketball player growing up was Dikembe Mutombo. Do you guys know who that is? All right. If you know nothing about basketball, Dikembe Mutombo was my favorite player based on name alone. If you don't know, his full name is Dikembe Mutombo Talanda Mukamba Jean-Jacques Mutombo. That's his full name. He's got two sons. He named his first son Dikembe Mutombo Talanda Mukamba Jean-Jacques Mutombo Jr. And I'll try to pronounce his second son's name for you and not stumble over it. Ryan. He's definitely playing favorites. Family name is skewed way over to the first kid. You know Ryan gets stuck doing the most chores in that house. In that house, it's a lot of, I need somebody to mow the lawn. Dikembe Mutombo to... Fuck it! Ryan! My friend wanted me to dog sit for him for the weekend, and I agreed to do it, but he wanted me to go to his apartment first to make sure that me and his dog got along before he left us alone for the weekend. I went to his apartment, me and the dog got along fine. He's got a little schnauzer named Rory, who I took the liberty of renaming Doogie Schnauzer for the weekend, because that's a better name for a schnauzer. If you have a dog, you should always name it based on the breed that it is. Like, if you have a Basset Hound, name it Angela Basset Hound, right? Why would you not do that? If you have a Shih Tzu, name it Shih Tzu de Chanel. Or Golden Retriever Longoria. Chihuahua Walters. Salvador Collie. Labrador Dolly. Masalva Border Dolly Culkin. Write that one down. It's got a lot. You can build. If you have a boy pug, name it Michael Pugless. If you have a girl pug, Pugly Betty. If you have four pugs, name them Bone Pugs in Harmony. You get how it works. Me and the dog got along fine. He goes, he's yours in the morning, but keep an eye out on him. Earlier today, he got under my bed and ate a plastic bag. So the next day, I took the dog out for the first time. He did his thing on the sidewalk. Everything came out fine. I looked down, saw the dog had a little tip of a plastic bag coming out of his butt. I was like, oh no, I have to get that out right now. It's probably bad for a dog to be walking around with a bag inside of it, and it's definitely embarrassing for both of us. And dogs will make eye contact with you like a lot of other animals won't, and so me and the dog just shared a moment looking at each other on the street. And he's looking at me like, come on, man, I'm not even your dog. Like, we just met. And I'm like, sorry, dudes, we're going through this together. I got down on my knees on the street and I lifted his tail with his hand, very gently grabbed the tip of the plastic bag with my other hand, and started slowly pulling the bag out of the dog. And it came out far enough to where it wasn't like a Ziploc bag that this dog swallowed. And it came out further, or it wasn't like a grocery store bag either. This dog swallowed a tall kitchen bag. Hadn't digested any of it. So I had this arm up here, a full arm's length out, a bag here. I looked up and this crowd of people had gathered across the street and just watching me pull the bag out of the dog. And they're looking at me like, that is the worst street magician we have ever seen. Thank you guys so much. You guys are awesome.
Good job. Let's hear for Adam one more time.